Good morning, students. How are you all? I hope you all are in your best of your health, staying at home and taking all the necessary precautions. Now, as lockdown has extended up to 15th of April and we don't know at what time it will stay, to utilize the time, we are here with the 12th standard chapter, Introduction to the 12th Standard. I have taken the reference from NCERT book, that is CBSC book, because the syllabus is almost same. I think name of the chapter is same and content would be somewhat different. But to start with, I have taken the reference from the CBSC textbook. You can download CBSC textbook from Google Play and refer the textbook. I have started with chapter number physics 2. There are two parts, physics 1 and physics 2. I have started with chapter number 11, dual nature of radiation and matter. This is as per the new syllabus. I hope you all are having new syllabus. Introduction, and we'll start with chapter number 11, dual nature of radiation and matter. Sorry. Now, there is the word radiation. Radiation. What do you mean by radiation? Now, the topics which are covered here is introduction, what is radiation, electron emission, photoelectric effect. In this topic, there are three subtopics: Hertz observation, Hall-Watts and Reinhardt's observation, experimental study of photoelectric effect. This topic we have to cover today. Now, first of all, introduction. Now, as already asked the question, what do you mean by radiation? In 11th standard, we have seen electromagnetic waves. The waves which do not require any material medium for the transmission, they are all called as electromagnetic waves. That is the radiation. Radiation is the waves emitted by the particle are called as radiation. In 10th standard also, you have seen what do you mean by radiation. There are many materials which, when exposed to light, emits the alpha, beta and gamma rays. This is called as radiation. Now, many scientists like J.J. Thomson, Hertz, Leonards has proposed their theory that the particle when exposed to light emits alpha, beta and gamma rays. So, as the time goes on, discovery of electron, mass of electron, charge on electron are discovered by Millikan and many more physicists. So, the discovery of everything is covered into introduction part. To move on, the important topic here is electron emission. Now, let us think in this way. In nucleus, this is a positively charged nucleus. Electrons are revolving around the nucleus. Electrons are negatively charged. These electrons are binded by electromotive force. Electrostatic force, you can say electrostatic force. Nucleus apply electrostatic force to the electron. And that is why electron revolves around the nucleus. Now, if I want to free this electron from this particular atom, I have to apply the force so that it will break the bond and ready to move out of the metal. That is called as emission. Emission is to get out. Electron emission. Now, as we have seen here, we have to apply force. Now, this force can be applied in many ways. So, there are three types of electron emission. First is thermionic emission. Second is field emission. And third one is photoelectric emission. As the name suggests, thermionic is to give the temperature. We have to apply the temperature to this atom so that electron will get kinetic energy. Sorry. So if they get kinetic energy, their energy will increase and the bond between nucleus and electron will be broken by that particular kinetic energy or the temperature we have given from outside, and electron will free to move. That is called as thermionic emission. Field emission, field. Now there are two fields, electric field and magnetic field, but here we want only electro. There is nothing like magnetic field here described. So we have to apply strong electric field to free electron from the nucleus. So that is called as field emission. And next one, C, photoelectric emission. Photo is what? Now important thing, photo, the word derived is from photon. Photons are the packets of energy from light, source of light, or you can say light, photon. Electric, that is electron. So when light energy, that is photon, strikes on the electron, electron will gain energy from photon and it will be free from the nucleus. That is called as photoelectric emission. We have to provide a suitable frequency light, let us say ultraviolet light, to this particular atom. That is, energy in the form of photon is given to electron to break the bond so that it will be out of the metal surface. This process is called as photoelectric emission. Again, electron emission, which are of three types. First is thermionic emission, that is based on temperature. Second is field emission, which is based on strong electric field. And third one is photoelectric emission, which is based on photon and electron. So we'll move ahead in this topic. The third topic was photoelectric effect. Now, Hertz observation. Now, Hertz is the name of physicist who has observed when a frequency of a particular frequency of light is incident. See, this is source of light. These are photon. Assume these are packets of energy photon. When they are incident on particular atom, let us say cesium or potassium. Now, as we know, every atom has a different configuration. The bond between nucleus and electron is different. That is, energy of breaking the bond will be different for different elements. So, a particular frequency, and this bond breaking energy is different for different atom, and this bond breaking energy is also called as work function. Is also called as what? Work function is denoted by φ0 in electron volt. Okay, one electron volt is 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19 volt. Remember this. Work function. What is work function? It is the energy required to break the bond. Energy required to break the bond between nucleus and electron is called as a work function, and it is measured in electron volt always. Now, this photon has energy, and according to Hertz, one photon has energy equals to h into nu. Energy in one photon is equals to h into nu, where h is Planck's constant and nu is the frequency of incident light. This is the source of light, this is the frequency of incident light. Now, a particular energy. As we say, we require a particular energy to break the bond. So we required a particular frequency of light. After that only the bond will break. Now suppose, for example, this, I'll give a number just to explain. This bond is of 100 electron volt. So my frequency of light should be greater than this. Energy in a photon should be greater than this. If it is less than this, the bond will not be broken, an electron will not come out from the metal surface. So a particular frequency is required to break the bond. At the particular frequency, that particular frequency is known as threshold frequency. Threshold. It is the minimum frequency at which electron will come out from the metal surface. Electron will come out from the metal surface. That is called as threshold frequency. These are the Hertz observation. Now, when he met, this observation is given to Hallwasch and Lennard's observation. On the basis of Hertz observation, Lennard and Hallwasch started assuming that which material will emit electron, and they started experimenting, and they have seen this phenomena in many material like potassium, cesium, almost all types of metal, when bombarded with a particular frequency of light emits the electron. When bombarded with particular frequency of light will emit the electron. They proved it in the laboratory that electrons are coming out from the metal surface when they are exposed to a ultraviolet rays. These are their observation. Okay. And in laboratory they have experimented how the electrons are coming out from the metal surface. So next point will be experimental study of photoelectric effect. Now for this we need a diagram. This is the evacuated. Evacuated means there is no atmosphere inside, or you can say vacuum. A vacuum tube is used for the experiment. This is the source of light of a particular frequency, required frequency. This is a metal plate. This is a metal plate. When the light is incident, it emits electrons. So these are electrons moving with some kinetic energy. This is the circuit diagram. I will complete the circuit diagram, but let me give. This is evacuated glass tube. This is source of light. This is metal plate. This is cathode anode. This is moving towards positive terminal. These are electron. Okay. Refer the textbook for diagram. Here is the voltmeter. Here you can take output of electric current which is produced. Here it is ammeter to measure the current. This is commutator key. Commutator. This has very important role to play. Commutator key. plus minus, this is R, we can say we can take output. Now, this is very easy experiment. This is experimental study of photoelectric effect, how the electrons will come out when the light of particular frequency is incident on the metal plate. This is a metal plate, or you can say photosensitive plate. Both are same, photosensitive. Photosensitive means when photons will strike on the metal plate, electron will come out. This is evacuated or vacuum tube. Metal plate or photosensitive plate is placed here. When the source of light is incident, the electrons are coming out with some kinetic energy. As electrons are negatively charged, they are attracted towards the positive terminal of the tube, and as soon as the circuit is completed, we will have some potential difference between cathode and anode, and the current in micro ampere is measured by emitter, and we can use this current as we require. When the source of light has changed, the effect on the electron emission can be seen and noted by the experimental study or by Hallwash and Leonard. So here they have varied potential difference, they have varied frequency of light, they have varied intensity of light, and they have replaced this metal plate. And in all the cases, they study different emission or different electron photon combination, and this is covered in experimental study of photoelectric effect. So in coming lecture, I'll continue with this photoelectric effect. By the help of commutator key, we can increase or decrease the potential difference. By changing the source of light, we can change the frequency of incident light, and by replacing this metal plate with other metal plate, we can change the material of the metal plate. So in all the cases, what will be the change in emission, this we will see in coming lecture. Till then, go through 12th standard CBSC book for more information. Ask the doubts to us. Utilize your time very nicely. All the best. See you soon. Thank you very much.